And as we grow, tell me why can't we grow together?
Canada. I'm from Los Angeles, California, and I play for UCLA. I mean, experiencing, you know, different sides and different places. I mean, when I was younger, I went to elementary school in Brentwood, and you know, that was, you know, that type of nice neighborhood, nice area. Then transitioning, going to View Park, which is like Crenshaw, in that type of neighborhood, and then going to Wynwood, which is back over in Culver City. So just experiencing different places all over LA. And the basketball aspect, you know, traveling and playing in different sites in LA, going to Orange County or Rancho Cucamonga, wherever it may be. So just experiencing those different sides, it just made me, you know, realize like how fortunate I am wherever I'm at the time playing basketball, wherever school I'm attending, and I just feel like, you know, seeing different places is just what made me in LA. So I'm actually the total opposite. Like, people say that when I step on the court, like, I'm just a totally different person. But like off the court, I'm the complete opposite. You know, I'm very shy at first, and then, you know, once I start to talk to people and hang out with them, then, you know, I get a little more relaxed. But I'm very chill off the court. I don't really do much. I mean, I hang out with my friends, but other than that, like, my most comfortable thing is like just staying in my room, just chilling, watching TV and listening to music. But people say that sometimes they don't really know who I am just because I'm just like two different people when I step on the court and when I'm off the court, so.
Well, you know, obviously the first initial thing is the girl can play. I mean, you know, I remember going to watch her in Atlanta when she was an itty bitty. And she always tells me, I still call her itty bitty sometimes when it makes her mad. She says she's not an itty bitty. But I remember watching her. She really was the smallest person on the court at that time. But she had sort of a quiet swagger about her even then. And, you know, as much as her game has gotten bigger and maybe her notoriety has gotten bigger, she's still got the quiet side, too. And it's just, she sort of has a quiet confidence about her. You could tell she loved the game. And the other thing you could tell really early on is that she loved the big moments. But what's harder to teach is that sort of emotional it factor, that the higher the pressure, the better they do. And I could tell early on that Jordin Canada had that it factor.
Really humble. I mean, mostly kids in this day and age, they're bragging about all their things they do and whatnot, and Jordan's not into that. and she's great at basketball and she loves it, but she's not just about that. She cares about how she treats people. She cares about her teammates. She cares about the world. And that really makes her special when you add that with being a fantastically talented athlete.
Goals is to make it to the pros, play professionally overseas, do summer camps, give back, working with one of my club coaches, who's when I first started GBL Lady Rebels, she's still doing that organization. So hopefully just like helping her with whatever she needs and just being involved in the basketball community in whatever way possible.
I think I really love watching her develop deeper and deeper relationships with unpredictable people. I think I love watching her relationship with Coach Shannon, and Coach Shannon is probably who she's closest to in the program. I love watching that mentoring process take place and her in Coach Shannon's leadership class, and not only watching her learn so much from Coach Shannon, who I know is such a phenomenal role model, but not just having them get closer and to know, I really think that will be a relationship she has for the rest of her life. And I really enjoy watching that transpire.
Coaching Jordin's been like a dream. You don't really get that many players in your lifetime that are that special. So it's been fun, it's been exciting, it's been a whirlwind. I mean, to have a kid of that caliber come in and be given, here's a team, take us somewhere. And to have that kind of responsibility so young, I think it was difficult, but I think it's the best thing that ever happened to her. I think we all benefit from that. I love, the thing that I'm passionate about is basketball is just something that you do, it's not who you are. So for her just to be such a dynamic basketball player, and she's just being true to who she is off the court. So it's just something that she's great at doing, but there's so much more to her than just her ability to play basketball. To see how she loves kids or animals, she loves singing. There's so many aspects of who she is as a person, and I don't like people to limit our players. So that's why the theme here is I Am Woman. I want them to be able to celebrate all that they are, not just one thing that they do.
Family, I think that's the number one thing. Having friends, you know, who understand what it's like to be in this type of, you know, no, I wouldn't say industry, but, you know, basketball community, people that care about me, I care about them. That's pretty much it. Everything else is like, you know, you never know what to expect, but I think that's what matters is friends, family, and basketball. I mean, at the end of the day, basketball is gonna come and go. You can't play basketball forever. So it's all about how the way you carry yourself as a person, the people you hang around with, and just be very intentional and caring. I mean, that's my personality before I got to UCLA, and just being able to keep that going into college and, you know, me having all the notoriety that I get, it's always the key to just, you know, stay humble and just be the person you are, no matter if it's about basketball or whatever it may be. And, you know, my parents take great pride in that. They always tell me just to remain humble and be modest no matter what's going on in your life. And that's just something that I just carry with me. When meeting a new person or somebody that I don't know, a stranger, and just always being nice, because you never know what's gonna happen, you know. What goes around comes around, so I believe in good karma and just, you know, always just being true to myself.